From America's election headquarters, new Fox polls taken this week show Donald Trump widening his lead nationally while the race tightens between Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders. Take a look at this. Among likely Republican voters, 45% prefer Trump as their nominee. Ted Cruz, John Kasich, they're nearly tied at 27 and 25%. And Bernie Sanders gaining more than 10 points on Hillary Clinton since just last month, nearly tying it up. She now has support from 48% of Democratic voters. Sanders is coming in at 46%. So let's bring in Julian Epstein, a Democratic strategist and former chief counsel for the House Judiciary Committee, and Ian Pryor. He's a communications director for American Crossroads, a Republican super PAC. Thank you for joining us. So let's talk about those numbers and what has changed. Ian, I'll start with you. Back in March, Trump was leading over Cruz by just 3%. Now he has a double-digit lead. We mentioned Bernie Sanders. He's closing that gap with Hillary Clinton. So what is changing?
Well, I think if you look at the Trump numbers, let's go back to that poll that you just referenced. That was in a very difficult time for the Trump campaign. That was in the middle of the incident where his campaign manager was being accused of battery. He had the awful response on abortion. He was attacking Heidi Cruz. It was really the worst part of the Trump campaign. But since then, since Wisconsin, things have calmed down a bit. He's brought in some more experienced hands to help with his campaign. He's been a little more quiet on Twitter, et cetera. And, you know, just the other day, he had this town hall with his family present. I think that went very well for him. It really humanized him and showed a different side of Donald Trump, plus the fact that we're in New York. It's his home state. All eyes are on New York. And I think that's why you have this reassurance bump for Donald Trump in the polls.
And, Julian, what do you think?
Well, I still think Donald Trump is not going to be the nominee, not just because he's toxic in a general election. Polls show 7 out of 10 voters don't like him, 2 out of 3 independents don't like him, but I think because most Republicans still don't like him. I still think even though that poll shows Trump far ahead, you're going to go into the Republican convention in Cleveland in most likely a brokered convention, and most of the delegates at that convention will be anti-Trump. Mm-hmm. So I think I don't know how it will coalesce, but I can't see it coalescing in favor of Trump, particularly in light of all the new polls that are coming out that are just saying, you know, 7 in 10 voters having a negative view of him. That's almost impossible to win a general election. Mm-hmm. You look at his numbers in the Electoral College, and they're in the tank. So I think Republicans will get smart, put up someone like Kasich and Cruz, and either of those two candidates have a very, very good shot in the general election.
Yeah, and speaking of honesty and dependability and all of those issues that Hillary Clinton has been facing, well, how do you think she fared last night in the Democratic debate? Do you think that she came across as being more authentic or less authentic? Julian.
Well, I think it was a slugfest. I think both candidates scored points. I think she is good as she normally is in kind of understanding the substance, making the practical argument that I can get things done. I think that's still resonating. If you look at her numbers, she's won 2.4 million more votes than Bernie Sanders. She's got 60% of essentially the electorate right now. She's far ahead, the Democratic primary electorate. She's far ahead on pledged delegates. Mm-hmm. Right now she's on a trajectory where she'll win by about 4 million votes in the primary election. So even if it's a contested convention, if she has a majority of the popular vote, it's going to be very difficult for the superdelegates to go anywhere other than Hillary.
I want to take a look at this poll. This is very interesting. Two different polls, and Ian, I'll get you to respond to this first. In this first poll, it talks about Kasich beating Hillary Clinton. When you put them up against each other, Kasich is the one who has the best chance, coming in at 49% of beating Hillary Clinton. Cruz, 44%. Trump loses that one at 41%. But what's interesting, take a look at this poll. In this poll, still voters think, when you're asked this question straight out, who has the best chance of beating Hillary, you have Trump at 42%, Cruz at 24%, and then Kasich at 20% there. So why the discrepancy, do you think, Ian?
You know, I'm not really sure. It seems like that's opposite day there. But yeah. I do agree with Julian on Kasich and Cruz. I mean, these are These are two candidates that, have a very good chance of beating Hillary Clinton, especially John Kasich. But I think that the Democrats have been underestimating Ted Cruz a bit. I mean, he's basically tied with Hillary Clinton nationally. When you get into those battleground states, those purple states, those numbers are going to be more favorable to Cruz. So, you know, I think Cruz has run really a top-notch campaign, and Democrats would be unwise to underestimate him. Now, the other thing that I find interesting is that Bernie Sanders performs better against all of the Republicans than Hillary Clinton does. Now, a year ago, right, ago, conventional wisdom would be, oh, Hillary Clinton is the best candidate that Democrats have to offer. Well, today, that conventional wisdom doesn't seem very wise, because I think Bernie Sanders right now would be a tougher general election opponent for Republicans.
All right, well, speaking of Sanders, we have to talk about this. One of the questions that was asked in this latest Fox News poll left a lot of people scratching their heads. We asked, who do you trust more to negotiate with Putin? And this is against the Republican candidates at this point, Cruz and Trump. Look who bests both of them. Bernie Sanders. You trust Bernie Sanders more than Cruz or Trump to negotiate with Putin. What's your response to that, Julian?
I don't know. I mean, that doesn't make... I think to Ian's point, and I agree with pretty much everything he said, I mean, I think Bernie is a stronger candidate in the general election right now only because the Republican attack machine hasn't unleashed on him. But give the Republican attack machine, which is very effective, a couple of months, and you can see all of the material on the table that they could go after. So I think those numbers would change substantially. Ian is also correct. The one guy that the Democrats really fear more than anyone else is John Kasich, because all of the polling shows what a formidable candidate he would be and how appealing he is to independents. Hillary still has a real big problem with independents and swing voters. John Kasich does not. So so our nightmare candidate from a totally partisan point of view would be John Kasich.
Although
I think, you know, I think the guy's a wonderful guy. I just think, you know, from a partisan point of view, we fear him because we fear he would be so strong in a general election.
Yeah, but would Putin fear him? Charles Krauthammer, if we have time for that, said he definitely didn't know what was going on with that poll. Can we take a listen to what he had to say? Listen.
One of your polls asked who would be the best position to negotiate with Putin, and if I'm not mistaken, Sanders wins on that, which tells you how insane the country has become.
Ian, what's your response? I mean, how insane the country has become.
Well, it's 2016. I mean, yesterday we were all glued to our TVs watching a Zapruder-like film from the Corey Lewandowski, Michelle Fields incident. I mean, this is crazy. And I think that, you know, all the rules are out the window with 2016. Things that we thought were, again, conventional wisdom, very wise.
Are no more. Julian, Ian, thank you so much. But it sure does make things exciting. Appreciate you joining
us.
Have a great weekend.
Thanks for having us.
You too.